Hello students, what we have read in the last video, we have read the French society during the last 18th century. What was there? I told you about the Louis XVI belongs to the Bourbon family, and what he was the king, and he became the king at the age of 20 years. And then what was there? He married with the Austrian princess. And he imposed a lot of taxes because of his treasury was empty, right? Now I told you that also that the society was divided into three categories. The society was divided into three categories. That is first estate, second estate, and third estate, right? And third estate they have to pay all the taxes. The third estate they have to pay all the taxes. So who were the sufferer that time? The third estate was the sufferer of that time, right? So in this video we are going to discuss about unit 1.1 and the struggle to survive. That is the struggle to survive, and we can say subsistence crisis. Struggle to survive means fight, struggle to do hard work for the survival, for their livelihood. That is known as subsistence crisis also. Subsistence crisis means, subsistence means your livelihood. Subsistence means your that you want to live in society, right? What is necessary for the life, that is cloth, shelter, and food. And it is very hard to earn these things. It is very hard to learn these things is known as the subsistence crisis. Why this was there in France? Why this was there in France? Because the population of France was increasing. The population of France rose from about 23 million to 28 million in 1789. And in 1789 what happened? There was the outbreak of the French Revolution on 14 July 1789, and this led to a rapid increase. This led to a rapid increase in the demand of food grains. As the population will increase, then what will happen? The demand for food grain will also increase, right? Then production of food grains could not keep pace with the demand. What happened? Then the population was increasing, but the production was not increasing with the speed that the speed the population was increasing. At the speed population was increasing, at that speed the food grains were not increasing. The food grains were increasing at the same pace, means with very slow speed, right? So most of the workers were employed as laborers in workshop whose owner fixed their wages. Their wages were fixed, but the prices of the food grains was increasing. It means earlier their real income was declining. What was their real income was declining. Whose real income was declining? Laborers. Because suppose earlier they were earning 100 rupee and they were able to purchase 10 kg of wheat. Now they are earning the same, but they are able to earn only 9 kg or 8 kg of wheat. So their real income was declining, right? But same thing I told you, but the wages did not keep pace with the rise in prices. The prices of food grains were increasing, but their wages were same. So the gap between the poor and rich widened. Why the prices of food grains were increasing? The reason, one reason was the high population. When population is high, then the demand of the food grains will be high. If the demand will be high and the supply is less. Suppose in market, you went in market, then what happened? You want to purchase a shirt and only 10 shirts are there in the market, but the person, those who want to purchase the same kind of shirt are 100. So द सप्लाई इज लेस एंड द डिमांड इज मोर. सो हु विल परचेज दैट शर्ट? द पर्सन हु इज हैविंग द मोर मनी. और द पर्सन विल इंक्रीज द मनी. द पर्सन हु इज सेलिंग he विल इंक्रीज द प्राइस ऑफ दैट थिंग. इट मीन्स when डिमांड इज मोर सप्लाई इज लेस देन वट विल बी देयर? देर विल बी इंक्रीज इन prices. सो दिस थिंग was there. there was high population. People were asking for more food grain, more large number of food grain, but the supply and the production was less. So they increased the food grain prices. And another reason was there, that the another reason for the increase in the food price, that was drought and famine. What was there? There were droughts, and these were the things became worse whenever drought and hail reduced the harvest. The condition become worse when the drought is there, or hail means ole padna, right? When they reduce the harvest, when the harvest reduced, then there was more worse condition. So this led to subsistence crisis. I told you what is subsistence crisis. An extreme situation where the basic means of livelihood are endangered. It is a condition where your basic livelihood things are in danger, right? Something that occurred frequently in France during the old regime. What was there? These type of conditions was happening during the old regime. Old regime means before the 1789. This was the unit 1.1, and in the next video we will discuss about the next topic. And our next topic is a growing middle class and we says an end to privileges, right? This we'll discuss in the next video. So revise the chapter carefully and watch the video very carefully. Thank you.